Cons. I divided it into three categories: story, characters, and effects. We'll start with the story. God damn it! The fucking plot sucks dick!
Seven mystics create the seven Dragon Balls, and oh my god, when the eclipse comes, the Uzaru will come and assist King Piccolo to destroy the world.
No, he doesn't want to destroy the world, he wants to protect it. Okay, whoever created fucking James Wong, god damn it. Okay, it's supposed to take place between Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. Right, okay, since when the hell does Piccolo want to actually destroy the world? If you watch Dragon Ball, he's just ruling the planet. He's not destroying the planet. Everyone's obeying his will, and he's hurt killing everyone. Okay, another big-ass fault. Why the fuck is Goku in school? Okay, even though it's for like 20 minutes, why the fuck is he in school? He's too stupid to be in school. The fuck is wrong with you people? God, you think you're going to impress the world? Oh my god, I meet Chi-Chi at school. Yeah, right. Like, that's going to be so badass. You can't punch a guy. You ran over my bike. Goku doesn't ride a fucking bike. Where the hell is this Nimbus cloud, you idiot? It's supposed, like, it would be great to show how we got the Nimbus cloud, you know? And whatever, people who haven't seen Dragon Ball know that, because, like, he uses it in the first episode of Dragon Ball Z and shit. Okay, let's go to characters. Bulma, you... Why? Why the hell isn't all your hair blue? Okay, and you don't use guns. Bulma doesn't fight. Okay, since when the hell have you ever seen her wield any type of weapon? Okay, your vehicle's pretty damn awesome, but why the hell do you have guns? Since when the hell is that in the TV show? She doesn't shoot anybody. She's never hurt anybody. She's pathetic. Okay, your hair needs to be blue. Okay, as for the character-wise being all, you know, I want to do it this way, I'm awesome, you know, that's fine. Capsule Corp, okay, that was pretty cool. Next is Goku. He needs to be stupider. Okay, he has too much common sense in the movie. He needs to be toned down. I mean, he did crash and hit his head on the ground. I mean, come on, out of a Saiyan pod, you know, so that should, like, knock some sense out of his head, because in a TV show, he's not actually smart. Also, like, his hair just needs to be better, okay? Goku's not a brunette. Okay, and also, Goku's not white. He's Asian. Okay, if anything, he's not a white person. Okay, white person would be fucking Super Saiyan, but we're not gonna go there. That's just stupid. But, no, Goku needs to fucking be an Asian guy. Okay, that would look more like Goku, and plus, you need to fix the fucking hair. It needs to be like the wigs people create, you know? It'd be great if you idiots actually went out and bought that kind of hair. That would make more sense. The Goku hair to be bigger. Okay, I do like the effect, how, like, it comes back after he tries to gel it, okay? Next. Why the hell is Grandpa Gohan still alive? Why is he still alive? Okay. He should have been dead since he was not seen at all during, like, Dragon Ball. I never saw him. Okay? Why the hell is he alive? Okay, Piccolo didn't kill Gohan. Okay, all you fanboys of Dragon Ball series, correct me if I'm wrong, because I really don't know how he died. When I watched it, I watched, like, half of it. I didn't see his ass. Okay, he was just in Budokai Tenkaichi 2. But, anywho, and he doesn't know how to fight because he didn't teach Goku how to fight. Master Roshi taught him how to fight. And why the hell does Roshi not have a beard and the sunglasses? He always wears the sunglasses! Okay, you need to find some red fucking sunglasses with the shades and shit. You need to give him a big-ass white mustache, bald fucking head, and a big-ass beard like Tahir. Okay? Chain Fat's okay, he knows how to fight, that's for sure, but what the fuck? Okay, that's just pathetic. And, okay, why, next character, Piccolo. Okay, didn't Piccolo die in Dragon Ball? Isn't this between Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z? Why the hell is he still alive? Fuck, he needs to be dead already, so that should be Piccolo Jr., but he fights like he's fucking 89 years old. 890 years old. Why the fuck is King Piccolo still alive? And at the end of the movie, if you've seen this shit already, why the hell is he still alive? He should have been dead, spat out Piccolo Jr. Okay, fucking A. And if that is Piccolo Jr., you guys suck dick at making him look young. Okay, Piccolo Jr. should already be out and fighting a teenage Goku. Sorry. And also, like, he doesn't want to destroy the world. He just wants to rule the world. And why do you need the fucking dragon to rule the world? He was already doing it in Dragon Ball, in his floaty little chair shit, until Goku comes along and then gets in his fucking way. God, this entire fucking story sucks dick. Oh, my God. Effects. The beam. Okay. A Kamehameha, first of all, does not bring someone back to life. It hurts people. Number two, a Kamehameha doesn't look like smoke. It looks like a blue aura around a white beam. Okay, and it's Kamehameha, not Kamehameha. It's all together. It's called a Kamehameha. You fucking idiot. Jeez, man. Okay, and the end Kamehameha was great. Okay, that was great. But why the hell does Piccolo have red beams? Piccolo is never able to conjure up anything red except for his eye beams. Or maybe the little slide mess up or whatever when he does the special beam cannon. He has yellow. Look at Hellzone Grenade. Look at fucking Light Grenade. Okay, and Masenko. Those are all yellow. Fucking A. And what the hell is with airbending and learning how to do that? Okay, Goku never learned. You don't learn how to airbend in fucking Dragon Ball Z. You learn how to kick ass. Okay, soaring dragon strike, whatever the fuck that is. That's not a move in Dragon Ball Z. Okay, another issue, the fighting. It was way too slow. Okay, it was mostly on the ground. The fuck is that? Dragon Ball Z is all about fighting in the air. Super high speeds. When Goku was punching against Roshi, and Roshi was just... Okay, that's how it should have been the entire movie, with all the fights. And also with the... and shit. You know? Or, I don't know, I don't think they learned how to do hyperspeed until, like, later in Dragon Ball, and like, until Dragon Ball Z. Anyway. The fighting sucked ass. Okay, it really sucked ass. Okay, sorry, going back to characters. Yamcha, okay, his character's okay. You got an Asian! Very good job! Yamcha's not blonde. Yamcha's not blonde. He has hair growing all the way down his ass. He's a thief. Okay, nice car, but where the fuck is Puar? Where the hell is Krillin? My God, you idiots! Where the fuck are these people? Krillin was with him his whole life. Puar, they met Yamcha and Puar when he was a kid. They met all the fucking characters until he's a kid. Why the hell do they meet when he's a teenager? I don't care if this is alternate reality. If he's a fucking teenager, why the hell does this movie suck? Damn it, I can make a better video. Shit. And if you want to know a better video, I posted a link over here. And, like, this is how Dragon Ball, like, the fight scenes and shit should be done. It's Great Saiyan Man versus Android 17 and 18. Some foreign-ass language. I don't know. But as for the last effects, Shenron for American, Shenlong for Asian, fucking is stupid. He looks like a goddamn video game character. You guys could not suck dick harder than with that character. Holy shit. And why didn't he talk? He's supposed to say, "What is your wish?" Or like, and not only that, dude, he doesn't fucking talk. "Your wish has been granted." And he needs to cover the fucking sky. Also, the sky needs to be black. Hello? Why the hell does it look like heaven and shit when he comes? And Shenron doesn't go, whoa. He has red eyes and they glow whenever a wish is fucking granted. Where the hell are the long whiskers? Where are the tiny little arms? Where the hell is the long body? Fuck this movie! That is all I have to say.